interest at all in the body. In 1832, I had a case. John Murder was accused of poisoning his grandpa with some coffee. Coffee laced with arsenic. I knew if I tested the drink that I can find the arsenic. Judge and jury that Burtle killed his grandpa. So I, James Marsh, the chemist, got to working on the coffee with an arsenic test. I knew if I could find the arsenic, Burtle would be sent to jail really soon. Would be sent to jail really soon. I got the coffee sample and mixed it with hydrogen sulfide and hydrochloric acid. I detected yellow arsenic trisulfide, so I knew that Burtle killed the guy. And I showed the results to the jury. But by that time, it deteriorated, so Burtle was then acquitted. I couldn't believe it at all. Oh, that verdict really stung. So I decided to make a brand new test to find tiny traces of arsenic. I got to work immediately to change toxicology. Working, putting a sample into a flask. Then mixing it with zinc and sulfuric acid. It formed arsine gas, which was dried and heated. Then it left behind a black mirror substance. Left behind a black mirror substance. Now I call this process the Marsh test, and I published it in 1836, and it changed toxicology. It was able to find the smallest trace and measure the amount of arsenic in food and drink and the human body. The existence of the Marsh test made arsenic poisonings decrease. No one wanted to poison, 'cause my test could prove their crime. It ended up winning worldwide acclaim and became standard procedure. And it was the beginning of forensic toxicology.